Hey guys, my name is Nick, and welcome back to another unboxing video. Today felt like a good time to open up this last Ultra Prism pre-release kit that I got. I've been postponing this one for a bit because I already opened four of them, and that felt like we did enough of them at the time. But I got a fifth one that I never showed you guys, so we're doing that today. So this will pretty much be the same deal as with my other pre-release videos. There's the little 22 card deck and the four booster packs, which I have already opened because I played with those cards. But then I put everything back to sort of share the experience with you guys, because I'm not gonna open these things with a camera while I'm at the pre-release or something, because that's very noisy, and that also seems very awkward towards the other people who sit at my table. That's why I do it like this. Now, as usual, I will be giving away the codes for the booster packs. First, we have the winners from the Kangaskhan EX video, not the Zygarde video. We'll do that one on Monday, I think. I asked you guys if you wanted to win a code for one of these Kangaskhan EX or just one of the booster packs, and I think I said it in the last video as well, but the way I picked the winners was just I picked six random winners using a random number generator, and of the six numbers I looked at the first two that said they wanted to enter for the Kangaskhan EX, and they got the Kangaskhan EX, and the other four will get a code for the booster pack. So it was completely random and equal chances no matter what you entered for. And so the winners of the Kangaskhan EX cards were GameX and Ashton. You guys should have received a code which allows you to receive this card in the online TCG. And the winners for the booster packs were Scala333, Cyril Sapp, Vanessa PM, and Xerox Visual. So you should all have received the message from me by the time you see this video. As for the codes from this video, we're gonna look at one thing inside this box, because the question I'm gonna ask you guys is about that. So we're gonna start opening it right away, because the thing is, these pre-release kits always give a promo along with 22 cards and 4 booster packs. And if you watch the first 4 Ultra Prism pre-release promo videos, you know that I already had all 4 of the promos. So I got another Lucario in this one, and I managed to trade it for something very nice, and I'm just gonna show you guys. I traded my Lucario promo for this Articuno full art from Generations. One of the few cards from Generations I was still looking for and really wanted to have. It's such a beautiful card. I was really happy to find someone who wanted to trade me this. Such a nice card. And I think it's definitely going to get a spot on the background along with Zapdos up there. Let's move the camera up a tiny bit so we can get a good look at that Zapdos as well. They are close enough. So we have Articuno and Zapdos. Zapdos still not quite on the frame, but sure. And so the question I want to ask you guys to win one of the Ultra Prism codes is, which of these two full arts is your favorite? The Articuno full art or the Zapdos full art? Let me know which one is your favorite and why in the comments below for a chance to win one of the Ultra Prism codes. Now let's see what else we got in this thing. Of course we got another flyer, which I turned into a Porygon already. Let's unfold the wings a bit, because I really want to show this one off, because I think this is the first time I actually managed to make a pretty decent one. Usually my paper Porygons end up physically challenged. But yeah, I think this one turned out pretty nice. What else we got? We got a random energy I picked up somewhere. And then we have the 22 card deck. Of course there's a Riolu, because I got the Lucario promo at the start. So along with Riolu we had Gible, and another Gible to Gabite, and obviously Garchomp chain. There's going to be a video, by the way, on the Garchomp deck, the theme deck that's with it, because interesting. Long story short, I think theme deck play is going to be ruined for quite some time. So along with Garchomp we got Piplup to Empoleon, obviously. We get two different Piplups from the set, the Primplups, and there's the Empoleon. And then we also got a Yungoos to Gumshoes, also a very good card that identify. And we got a Shaymin, Spiritomb, and some trainers, Timer Ball, Nest Ball, Sophocles, and Howl, nothing special there. And then we have the four booster packs. Now I sort of remember what was in it. Not really, it's been a while, but I remember at least something. I just don't know in which pack. So let's take a look at our first pack here. For my first pack, I got a Fire Energy, Magmar, a Alolan Diglett, Skorupi, Monferno, Magnemite, Pokemon Fan Club, another Gabite, which, now that I see this, I remember the deck I used for this pre-release, which I'm gonna put you to the side, I'll show you in a second. We got a skateboard, we got a Gible Reverse Holo, and there it is. This is the one card I remembered pulling from this thing. I got a Crushing Hammer secret rare. The first secret rare from Ultra Prism, really. And it was funny as well, because I actually played it, and this is the only Crushing Hammer in the set, so no one was expecting it, which was quite fun to play with at the pre-release. And then we have three more packs to go. We have a Fighting Energy, Execute, Shinx, Stunky, Magnemite, Salandit, Cosmoem, Faulkner, Luxio, Reverse Holo is a Pokemon fan club, and the last card is a Licky Licky, which I don't think I have pulled since, so that's a nice rare. For the third pack, we have a Metal Energy, another Shinx, Bronzor, Salandit, Magnemite, Passimian, Fire Memory, Lopunny, Pokemon fan club, the reverse holo is a Rampardos, and the last card is a Shinnotic. Also very beautiful, by the way. And for the last pack, we had a Dark Energy, another Execute, Krogunk, Passimian, Buizel, another Gible, Unit Energy, Shieldon, Cynthia, reverse holo Primplup, and the last card is a Garchomp. So this is what I pulled from the packs, right? Gible to Garchomp, along with the two Gibbles, Gebhites and Garchomp I already had. I just played that Gible Garchomp deck for the pre-release and I did pretty well with it. Even got an extra Cynthia to go along with it and a Crushing Hammer, which worked out pretty well as well. So yeah, I did pretty nicely this pre-release. And of course this very nice pool to add to my collection. Along with this guy, I'm still so happy I got this. So yeah, that was it for my last Ultra Prism pre-release kit. I hope it was still fun to watch, even though the pre-releases were some time ago. And of course, don't forget, if you want to win one of the Ultra Prism codes, let me know which of these two cards is your favorite, the Articuno Full Art or the Zapdos Full Art, in the comments below. And I'll pick my favorite answers and announce them in the next video. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, you can click up here to watch another one. And if you just want to watch me play some video games, you can click down here to go to my gaming channel. Whatever you decide to do, thank you very much for watching and have a very nice day.